Hello and welcome. Let's get on with it.
So we are done with our basic low poly models of our houses, and these are some additional accessories that I've made for just the dustbin. These both are the rooftop accessories that you can install on top of the buildings as well as on the houses. These are of course the same cars which we made from the parking lot scene. These assets I've just brought in. Now the pole and tree, which is again low poly as well, I'm going to show you how we are going to make the low poly tree. Just bring in the UV sphere and we're going to scale it a little bit in specific axes and add in the, this is the decimate modifier, which I'm altering the ratio, which will basically reduce the vertices. Now you'll see it's fairly low poly. Of course you can go and make a complicated shape. Now let's make the trunk, which is just by adding in a cylinder, scale it down, then bring it up in the z-axis. Then into the edit mode, let's add in some loop cuts and turn on, let's select face select mode, let's turn on the with this, if we turn it about, we can significantly make changes to the other vertices nearby as well. Let's decimate it as well, bring down the ratio, and you can see fairly good looking low poly trunk. Just a rough idea of how I went about it. Of course I just kept it simple, just one sphere. Of course you can go and add in a couple of spheres and scale and rotate them for different final look, something of this sort. Duplicate this, bring it up, scale it up as well. You get the idea. Now we'll be making the street lamp. As simple as adding in a cylinder, bringing down from here the vertices to 6. That's what I went for. Now I'm going to scale it down and then bring them to the Z axis. Edit mode, face select, extrude and scale, and then extrude again. Then again, it's a repetitive process. Extrude, and now let me do it a little bit more and let's turn that off and bring it down. And that looks like a lamppost. Now I will select these edges and I'm going to bevel them with one increment. That's going to add in the effect of the boundaries where the light has been restrained. Now of course I've used this human as a reference because the cars that I've model previously, turns out their scale is slightly off, hence I have scaled them to a size that looks more appropriate, of course by selecting all the parts of the car, and that's the final size that I went for. Of course I changed the size of the other cars as well, and these are the accessories. Now this is the scene that I have created. Of course you can go about making it as complicated as you want. Of course the first and most important thing is you need to make the roads, and once you have that, then you can keep duplicating them as and keep modeling the cars as the parking lot. So these are the color combinations that I've gone for and I am fairly liking it. So now you can just follow along and see the hex codes that I'm going to show you for each color combination that I've used. And you can record them or you can use it with the ones that you like. You can make a harmony by using in similar shades, or you can go the way I went about it by adding in 3 different colors. with all the hex references being clearly shown. As simple as that. It did take me quite a bit of time because of placing in all the individual items. Hence, I trimmed that part of the video. Of course, it's totally up to your preference how you want to go about it. These are, of course, the other ones. This is something additional, simply cuboids. Just colored them green and the base dark brownish or black, so you can something whatever you would prefer. These are, of course, the colors that I've used in the apartment building that I've made. That's the sea. These are the roads. That's the grass pattern that I got from the Blender kit. Just search for grass and you can select the one that you like. Go for the green or any other material that you find attractive. Of course, we are in the material preview. We are not in the rendered image. This is the rendered image. Rendered view, as I might say. And of course, that's the asphalt. That's the driveway for the garage. And you can use for this one, I've used the road material, which is these ones. I'm going to show you where did I exactly find it. It's somewhere exactly. That's the one. That's what I've applied. The only thing is you have to go into UV editing and make sure that this is how it's being placed. That's how you can make either a single or a double or even a multiple lane road. This one I made it myself by just bringing down the color all the way to zero, which is the hex code. And this is, of course, a slightly grayish tone that I went for, which is separating it both the lanes, actually. So that's how that will be in the final output. Up to you. So that's the camera angle that I chose, and of course the thumbnail that you'll be seeing. So thank you for watching. Stay tuned. Toodles.